Hi everyone, this is Marissa from My Papers, Paints and Pens, and I have finally finished my travel journal for 2020. I altered an old book, as you can see, and the cover was the same as this back cover, and I'm not a big fan of red, so I kind of did this on top of it. I decorated the cover with a little bit of canvas, and I just took out the threads and it gave this nice frilly fringe and put some music paper over that and then made a pocket with some more canvas that I did distress ink, the fringes. And inside the pocket there is this little, I can take it out. There we go. Kind of glued on. I have this mini journal, and what I would use for this is while I was traveling, just jot down maybe the names of the places that I had visited. Ooh. And, you know, quick notes about, well, while I'm in the car and things like that. And then during the night, I will put in right inside my journal. So that's just a little quick thing. And a lot of things I used from swaps that I got. For example, this, I don't know what you call them. What do they call them? They're not trims. They are what? Those little scrap trims that you sew up and glue up. I got that from a swap. This stamp die cut I got from a swap. The images from my little stamp, my little mushroom stamp. Here's my little mushroom stamp. These are from a Portuguese paper factory, and they did a limited number of these books with a whole bunch of things, and one of them had labels. And they print out in the old-fashioned way, so I was very excited to find that. And that is the cover. I've tied it up with this cotton strip trim thingy. It's basically this whole thing, right? They'd use this to make carpets. And what I did was I just soaked it up in some coffee, and it came out nice and brown and nice and vintagey. All right, so did that. And I did wind it up all the way back. So look how lovely that looks. That's all coffee stained. So anyway, opening it up, I made an envelope on the side. Now, I did stick this part together because I don't, if you follow me on Instagram, I wanted to cover this part because, as I said, I'm not a big fan of red. And I did cover it up on that side. But I did remember to make a pocket. And if you ask me how am I going to take out the things that are inside there, I have no idea. It's so tightly, it's such a tight fit, I don't know if I can take them out. But let me see if I can do that without tearing anything. Okay, there we go. So what I put in this little pocket here was a few of these little envelopes. Alright, so let's just put that right up here so I don't have to dig down deep inside there. And then I made this very large pocket envelope, okay, very nice dimension, so that I can shove in things that I find on my trip. And I do have something in here. No, I don't have anything in here. It's empty. That's just the backing of my paper. And decorated that with some washi tape. I did put some washi tape on the side because I know when I shove things in and take things out, I kind of tear this paper a little bit, so I did reinforce it with some washi tape. And then put some washi tape on this side because this does go all the way through the spine on the inside. So that's just a little bit of reinforcement. And this part of here, when you dismantle the book, this part is a very ugly part because it's where the glue is and mesh and whatever. So I just put that washi here, and it kind of looks great. This is also another little piece of canvas. It was stamped and it was from a swap that I've received. Love using my swaps. And then this is the inside. Sorry, my voice is very very fragile today. I do feel like a frog. Well, I have a frog in my throat. But I always feel like I have a frog in my throat. But today it's way worse. So this is my signature. And it is made up of old documents, envelopes, and simple lined paper, ledger paper, and simple clear printer paper. All right, and I used these little clusters of fabric and lace that I got from another swap. It was wonderful. She made me these beautiful clusters, and you can see my lighting is very bad, and I do apologize, my light broke. The one is right up here on the side of here. I had one on long one on the wall, and it would give me this lovely white light, excellent for my videos, and that kind of broke. It went kapoof. So now I have to use a, well, let me show you. So just to show you my setup, this is where I put my camera. Okay, just lean it on there and the film's down there. And then my light went from there to there. It was a long one and that kind of went kapoof. And now I put my son's, you know, what do you call this light for a desk light over here. Not very good solution, but it was the only thing I found. So anyway, let me just get back to where I was. All right, so continuing with the bad lighting, but hopefully you'll still see. So then just put a little charm on a safety pin, those round safety pins, on this gorgeous piece of, well, it's a tab, but it's a cluster of fabrics and laces. It's beautiful. And it is sari silk, and it is an Indian lady that did this. And it was so, so pretty, and I had to use it on my journal. And then flipping through old documents. These are some of my old documents. And if you like them, you can either swap with me, or you can purchase them on my eBay. I do participate in a lot of swaps. There's another old document. My ledger papers. The ledger papers were quite long. All right, they were long. So I just folded them up, and I made pockets. And then I just sewed them up. And I did do double stitching. Okay, with my itsy bitsy teeny weeny sewing machine, this wonderful little thing still works. It's amazing how this thing still works. It's, you know, you'd think this thing would break in like, I don't know, a week of using, but it still works. So I did do a double, very badly doubled stitch, but oh, you know, I'm not a good sewer. And then on the back, I did put some washi tape, those thin ones of washi tape, just to cover up the back parts, because that's no good. Anyway. So flipping through, nothing too fancy inside because it is a travel journal, so I will be writing a lot and also putting photos. I did include a little envelope, all right, just a little thing here. Photos will be printed with my sprocket, all right. I did buy an HP sprocket. Very happy about that. Very, very happy about that. I have been playing with it. And here's another one of those clusters that I used as a tab. It's so, so pretty. I love it. You know, she makes beautiful things. Some of the documents were big and I just folded it up. I could have sewn this part up here, all right, and made it a pocket. But, you know, maybe I'll do that when I'm traveling. It all depends on what I need when I'm traveling, when I'm journaling. And let's get to another. There's another one of those clusters that I used as a tab. So, so pretty. And another one of my ledger papers that I've sewed and I've made a pocket. And there's a washi tape just to hide the back part of the sewing. That's not so pretty. And that's the center of my signature. Another pocket. There's another one of those fabulous clusters, fabrics and lace that she made for me. And I used it as a tab. I did think of putting more, you know, charms hanging from the tabs, but I think that will just bug me. It will, you know, get in the way. So I just put one, and in the end, when I fill this whole thing up, in the end of the year, maybe I will decorate it more with some more charms. Another one of those bicycle envelopes. Here we go. This is actually not the envelope. This was the card that would go into this envelope. So it's like a kit, not a kit, but you know, this was the card where they would write on the card and they would stick it in the envelope, because this is the envelope. All right, and I got both of them. I got the cards and the envelope. That was very, very gorgeous find that I found. And another tab, little flower, very, very cute. I love these things. And more old papers, you know, more things. So this is very, very simple. And then at the back, I did a vellum envelope. And it's stuck down with a washi stamp. Okay. And inside this envelope is where I have all the elements that I think I will use, well, they're plan, you know, you plan when you think you will use when decorating or when filling up, when I journal my on my travel journal. This is what I think I will use. So what did I put in here? Let's go from back to front. I didn't make these. These were all I got from swaps. All right, from one little lady in Portugal. So I plan to use these. Let's just put them back in. And then I have these, which was also from a swap. I'm very, very happy to be using the things that I got from swaps. These are very, very cute. I love these labels with the mustaches. And then I made a booklet, a flowish booklet with some of my papers. All right. These you can also find in my Etsy store if you like. They're just little bits and pieces of, you know, one the papers that I've been tearing from. For example, when I made this the signature, I did tear some of the documents to fit in, and this is what was left of them. So I just put them in my booklet. So a lot of that's cute. I love these little ticket thingies. I got some of these handwritten documents as well. Coffee stain documents. This was from a swap I got from a lady. And green papers. KTM. Who remembers KTM? I remember KTM. And some of my tickets. I got four of them there. Alright. And that's it. And then some washi tapes. Now, some of these washi tapes I got from swaps. Others were purchased by myself. So, put a whole bunch of them there. Alright. Travel themed swaps. These are storm film strips, a whole bunch of colors, rainbow colors, gold one, very thin gold one, very thin colorful one, and these two I got from swaps as well. So very excited to use those. And then labels. These are from my label book that I bought, I spoke to you about a moment ago, and I just fussy cut them out, and well, they will be, they are all in here now. So waiting to be used. That was very exciting. And the back I left simple because I did put a vote or a poll in Instagram to ask if I should close this up or if I just leave it. And almost everyone told me to just leave it as it is. And I actually got a very cool suggestion was at the end of the year when I've had all my travel done, I would take two photos and put them one here and one here and do like a layout, a scrapbook layout of those. And that was a very good idea. So I like that idea. And that is it. And then of course, didn't tell you about these ones, but on the flip flap of this chunky envelope, I did include some of my fancy clips. All right. That I've had in my stash for such a long time. I'm sure I received this one in a swap because I don't remember buying these ones. I remember buying these ones, but I'm sure this one came from a swap as well. So that's it. That is a flip through of my travel journal for 2020. And I will be doing my first trip in March. So I will be taking this little one with me. And I will be filling it up with lots of journaling and some photos with my HP Sprocket. All right. Thanks for watching. Have a good week.